Hello, dissenters. My name is Etalyx, and I am here today returning to Rust with a brief update video for you concerning my experiences in Rust and where we're going in the future. On my last two Rust videos, they have been primarily guide-focused. This is not one of those. On those guide videos, I was playing on a whitelisted server with a very limited population, and it was great for me. It was a wonderful experience learning how to play the game, getting to make my own fort to my dream's potential, and getting to get a feel for what the game is actually like in a controlled environment. But I think it's time to open the floodgates a little bit, and that's why I've decided that I've had enough fun in Rust to get my own official community server. Now, before we go into details on that server, I want to let you know if you do not own Rust, please do not buy this game just because I got a server for it, okay? I want to put that disclaimer out there because there are some people out there who will hear, Etalyx got a server, I'm buying the game now. And I don't want you to do that because I am not making any guarantees as to how long I will be playing this game for. I could stop playing next month. I could stop playing Rust next week. It could be tomorrow. There will come a time where I will suddenly stop playing the game. And I don't want people to spend money on my account when they wouldn't normally otherwise. But if you do have the game or you are interested in it anyway, then you can check out all the details for the server down in the description. There is a link down there that will take you to information on how to connect to the server through Rust and how to check out the map so that you can get your bearings if you get in game. Note, there are not player locations on this map. And finally, you can see what plugins we're using because this is not a purist vanilla experience. We are using a gather mod that increases the rate of gathering by 2 times. So I think that's a fair compromise for people that normally like faster gathering, and then the people that also like purist vanilla. It's a nice happy medium. We also have death notifications to promote a better community. Note, there is no rule against raiding other people, so feel free to steal and kill to your heart's content as long as you're not griefing and purposefully tearing down people's structures or camping them, etc. You get the idea. There's a difference between harassment and raiding in this game, and we do promote a healthy raiding environment. That's the idea. Beyond those, there's not really much else. We have a day-night cycle modification, so day should be twice as long as night, and a couple things here or there. But those are the major modifications. More information, again, available down in the description. Speaking of the description, I encourage you to follow the link down there over to my Twitch profile, because odds are if you're watching this video, as it is brand new, I'm probably streaming now for a few hours, so head on over there and we can have some fun in the server. But if you're watching this after the fact, just ignore that. But then again, you could go over there and follow anyways, because I'm sure we'll be streaming something you might be interested in very soon. Speaking of something else you might be interested in, Ark Survival Evolved does come out very soon, and I do plan on playing that, and if I enjoy it, we might get a community server for that game as well, just to answer the questions that will inevitably arrive. I am looking forward to that myself, and I hope it's not a Stomping Land 2, and I hope that it's actually good. So we'll have to wait and find out. But for now, let's focus on Rust. I do not have a whitelist on the server, so anyone is welcome to join. I probably will start out with a whitelist on Ark just to make sure that everything is stable, and we'll go from there. But if anything should happen, and maybe people from outside the community start making their home in there and causing problems for our community members, we may have to institute some kind of whitelist here on the Rust server. But I hope that we can avoid that and let as many people as possible play, at least for now. So feel free to join in and make your home amongst us. The map is very comfy cozy, and I encourage you guys to join us over there on the Rust server. And I mentioned earlier, I don't know how long I'm going to be interested in playing Rust for, so you might be wondering, how long is the server going to go on for, Etalyx? Well, I can guarantee that it will be going for at least 2 months. So even if I were to stop playing tomorrow, I still continue to pay for the server for the next couple months. So you should be able to rest easy knowing that your stuff is permanently there, bar any server wipes that are made mandatory by game updates, which is inevitable at this point, let's be honest. So you probably will lose your stuff, actually, but then again, so will everyone else, so it'll be equal. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed this little video update. I wanted to make sure that everyone knew about my server, not just the people that follow me on Twitch. If you don't watch my streams at all, you're still welcome to go hang out and play over there on the server. I know there's probably a lot of you. It is only a 50-slot server, so if there is enough interest drummed up, I can upgrade that if necessary, but I'll be surprised if it is. So guys, let me know what you think down in the comments below, and I hope to see you over in the server soon, and also over on my stream, where we'll hopefully be playing this pretty frequently, at least for the time being. Thank you guys for watching. My name is Etalyx, and I hope to see you again with another Rust guide video, a proper one here, very soon.